guys, it's Francesco here. In today's video, we're going to be passing over to Kimberly Ann, who is doing a video here on this YouTube channel about the top 10 productivity apps that she recommends for business owners and entrepreneurs. This is a very specific list, so if you're looking for to apply these to a new project or a new business, this could be really great for you. So hopefully you enjoy it. I'll include her link to her channel in the description. She has a really brilliant YouTube channel dedicated to business tools and resources, as well as getting you set up, which is awesome. I'm doing a video over on her channel for top 10 productivity apps, so you'll be able to hear my recommendations there. Anyway guys, thank you for stopping by today. Thank you for Kimberly Ann for having me on her channel and also being on this channel. And I'll see you guys in a very, very, very soon. Cheers.
Hey guys, my name is Kim Jimenez and I'm a digital marketing strategist and the founder of The Business Lounge. And I'm so grateful and excited to be here in Francesco's channel to share with you guys my top 10 productivity apps. Now, like the majority of us, I also am pretty busy and I really appreciate, you know, having tools that can help me get more done in less time. Now, the first tool that I love and highly recommend is Gmail for Work. It's part of the Google Apps family and it is worth every penny. I think it's about $5 a month to run your email via Gmail. Highly, highly recommend it. But what I like most about Gmail is the fact that it has a lot of additional plugins or tools that you can use with it. One of my favorites is called Streak. Now, Streak is designed to be a sales tool, but if you're an entrepreneur or even if you're just a working professional, you're gonna love some of the features that it has. It allows you to actually send your emails at a later date, which is fantastic, and it builds an entire CRM system inside of Gmail. Now, in the business, we have a separate CRM, so we don't use Streak's CRM. However, I love the ability to send emails later. You can also go into the app and have, you know, a snooze button, which allows you to remove the email temporarily from your inbox and have it come back into your inbox at a later date unless someone replies to the email, which is brilliant and absolutely fantastic if you're trying to reach inbox zero, like a lot of us are. The third element I love about Streak is that it actually tracks whether someone has opened your email or not, and this helps me stay on top of things so that I'm not pestering people, right? If I know they've already opened the email and they know or have consumed the information, I don't have to resend it over and over again. Now, Streak has a whole set of additional power tools that you can use to take your Gmail inbox to the next level, but those are my favorite three. Tool number two is by far Trello, and we absolutely love using Trello, not just to collaborate within, you know, our team, but also for our own personal to-dos. I literally plan my entire life and my business inside of Trello, and yes, that includes doing grocery lists, making sure I'm staying on top of my YouTube videos, and of course planning courses, newsletters, all types of content and admin tasks inside of the business. Now, the whole premise of Trello is to organize your boards or projects into smaller tasks that you can accomplish. So you get to set cards that really just represent a sub-project or an individual task. And you move that task across the board from left to right once it's complete. Trello is incredibly versatile, so you could use it just to plan your to-do list or to plan things like your content calendar to keep track of sales and turn it into a CRM, or you could just use it as a collaboration board to help manage larger projects. I know Francesco has quite a few videos here on the channel on Trello that I'm sure he'll link in the description box below if you're just getting started, but it's one of those tools that I could not live without and I highly, highly recommend. If you're interested in learning how to get started, I have a full workflow board that you can literally steal off of my own individual Trello account, copy it into yours so that you at least have a starting point. Now, tool number three is related to Trello, but I love this tool as well. It's called Pomello, and if you're familiar with the Pomodoro technique, you're definitely going to enjoy the ability to use Trello following the Pomodoro technique. So basically, Pomello is a timer that allows you to set or work in 25-minute segments so that you can pick out your task, set the timer automatically, and then it'll actually give you a heads up as you're nearing the 25-minute mark. This helps you stay really accountable to make sure that you're not spending a crazy amount of time on smaller tasks and that you're really focused on that deep, important work in your business or in your professional life. Pomelo also allows you to see exactly what you're spending the most amount of time on in your business or again in your work. And so I highly, highly recommend checking it out. Francesco also has a video on this specific tool that I'm sure he'll link to as well in the description box. Tool number four is definitely Slack. And this is a very popular tool that a lot of teams use to collaborate and chat on. I love it because it's more than just a simple chat kind of room or a chat app. It allows me and my team to communicate, to share files. We actually get to add on a little bit more of that human interaction with things like GIFs and videos. And I love the simplicity of Slack. It also has an amazing Windows app. I'm pretty sure it's also available for Mac, so that you can have the chat open at any point in time, you know, while you're using your computer, and you don't necessarily have to have the browser open, which for me is a big perk. I also have the Slack app installed on my phone, and that way I can communicate with my team. I don't have to send back and forth emails all the time. We can revisit conversations that we talked about previously. So highly recommend Slack. You can also join multiple teams from a single account, which is really helpful, especially if you're managing client work. If you're into timers, then you're probably gonna really enjoy Toggle. And Toggle is another one of those productivity tools that has an amazing timer. It's more than just a timer, it's really just a time tracker. And I love that it also integrates with tools like Asana and Trello so that you can track the time that you're spending on individual tasks and then go in and maybe bill clients later. So I love having the time tracker. And if you upgrade to their paid plan, you can also use it as a way to keep track of billable hours if that's something that you're using or doing in your business or in your work. The next tool that I love and highly recommend is, of course, Google Calendar. And again, Francesco has quite a few videos on that specific topic on the channel. I love Google Calendar, especially when it comes down to really organizing my content and my life. And if you are, for example, planning your content, your YouTube content, or you're planning your blogs, or you're planning a promotional campaign or a marketing campaign, Google Calendar can really, really help with all of that, especially because you can organize different types of events into categories or separate calendars and see all of it at a glance. I like to plan my entire week in specific time blocks or time ranges, and it's what I teach our members to do inside the Business Lounge, and this strategy is super effective. So highly, highly recommend using Google Calendar, not just to make sure you're not missing meetings or appointments, but also to plan your entire week strategically so that you know exactly what you're going to be working on every single week, and then on top of it, really look at your entire strategy as it pertains to your business or marketing at a glance. You know, you can add goals and really start looking at how to structure your time more efficiently so that you're hitting your milestones, hitting productivity goals, and of course, you know, staying on top of your marketing and on top of your business. Now, if you're doing a lot of collaboration between team members or within your own business, clients, etc., highly recommend using Google Docs. And this is a very popular tool, of course. One of the features that I love about using Google Docs is the ability to leave comments right in line of the document. And this is something my team and I use all the time to collaborate, to share ideas, to make sure that we're really staying on top of our content. And this applies for everything from blog posts to newsletters to video scripts, anything creative that we're actually designing inside of the business. So highly recommend Google Docs. And of course, you know, if you're using any of the spreadsheets or you're using something like their slide show, I believe, app, those are fantastic as well. One of the keys to productivity, in my opinion, is really laying out the process that it takes for you to complete a task from A to Z. And a lot of times in business or in work, we don't really pay attention of all the things we do on a daily, weekly, and monthly basis that are just repeatable tasks. So one of the tools that I really love and recommend is called Sweet Process, and it's designed to help organizations really keep track of their workflows, of their systems, and of their processes in a very streamlined way. So Sweet Process actually enables you to document what it really takes to accomplish a task or a project in your business or in your work. And I feel like this is incredibly important because whenever we're doing tasks, we don't always realize how much time could be saved if we just had, you know, kind of like a checklist or a document that tells us exactly how to complete this task. And oftentimes, this is something that we kind of just put on our brain and expect our brain to remember. And we could save so much more time if we just had a document that just tells us exactly how to complete a specific project or a specific task. If you think about creating videos here on YouTube, for example, it's not as simple as just saying, you know, let's turn on the camera, shoot a video, and upload it to YouTube. There's a lot that goes into it, right? First, we're outlining kind of like that whole idea, brainstorming different topics, doing some research, creating a video outline, and that's all before we even press, you know, record on the camera. So if you have an outline like this set up for all the tasks that you accomplish in your business or in your work on a daily, weekly, or even monthly basis, it can help you save a lot of time. And this is especially helpful if you have a team and you're training them, right, to take over some of your responsibilities, or you're having different team members kind of share responsibilities in between them. And that way, everybody is on the same page. Whenever something changes in your business, you can just go into that specific process and switch it out, right? Edit the whole kind of experience so that every time someone completes that process or that task or that system in your business, they're doing it in a very correct and accurate way. And last but not least is one of my kind of ride or die tools that have been with me since the beginning of my business. It's called Screencastomatic. I love this little tool, and they have both a free version and a paid version. So this tool helps you to record screencasts of your, you know, computer screen. You can also record your camera or a combination of both. And I love how simple they actually make this process. I especially like that for an additional fee, monthly fee, you can actually host the videos with them. So this is something that I do. I create a lot in my business, not just for the training courses inside of the Business Lounge membership, but also for my team in general. So if I'm teaching them how to do something, or I'm making updates, or I just want to share an idea or break down a project, I will pull up my Screencast-O-Matic, shoot a really quick screenshot or screen video, screen recording, and then upload it to their cloud, and they just process a link that I can share with my team. So I love this tool. It's one of the tools that I use almost on a daily basis, and I highly, highly recommend you check it out. So those are my top 10 productivity tools, but now Francesco and I would love to hear from you. What are some of your favorite productivity apps or tools? Leave them in the comment section below. We'd love to hear from you. We're always looking for new suggestions, and I'm sure that it will spark a lot of amazing insight from Francesco's community. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. And if you're new around here on Francesco's channel, highly recommend that you consider subscribing. He shares amazing productivity videos, and he reviews a bunch of amazing tools that can really help you stay productive. Again, thank you so much, Francesco, for having me here on your channel. This was loads of fun, and I hope that we get to do it again. Oh, and before I forget, definitely come over to my channel so you can check out Francesco's top 10 productivity tools as well.